埋相機咧，可以交俾我啦，同埋交俾阿文仔啦，我哋會幫你揸住呢兩樣嘢，等你有足夠兩隻手咧，落咗去先交翻俾你嘅。
喺香港，中意潛水嘅人越嚟越多，除咗因為學費同埋出海嘅收費越嚟越普及，更多人對環保、生態嘅關注，亦都係個原因。眼前嘅水底係另外一個世界。眼前嘅一切宁静美丽，难怪我身边好多朋友都选择咗潜水嚟减压，释放城市生活带嚟嘅压力。阿 May 就系其中一个。
喺香港潜水，会发现好多色彩丰富、好精致嘅生物，吸引我停落嚟慢慢咁观察佢哋。而地球上有一种大型嘅海底生物，面对濒危嘅边缘。大家可能都会听过佢嘅名字，但系我就好想亲眼见到佢哋，所以就开始咗我呢一个旅程。
要同座流鲸畅泳，最近就要飞去南太平洋的汤加群岛，因为呢度是座流鲸每年进行迁徙的途径。他们夏天就会由赤道游去南极冰水的海域捕食，冬季就会再游回去温暖的海域交配繁殖。所以每年六月到十月，位于这条迁徙路线的汤加王国，就吸引了大批潜水的发烧友来到这里。
喺吊斯林再轉機過嚟依度去睇座流鲸，緊張同埋好興奮咯，同埋希望可以近啲見到佢哋就好啦，係啦。
Okay, guys. So today, what we're going to do is we're going to head out to fast sea. We're going to start moving at speed to the area where we've been seeing whales.
Paul 同 Kevin 係我哋嘅導遊，佢哋專門帶遊客去觀賞鯨魚。所以好熟悉座头鲸的脾性同埋出没的位置，跟住佢哋一定唔会失望。
Up right by side， 我望到好似有啲嘢夹上嚟，但系唔系好清楚，应该好远。其实睇鲸鱼咧，好多地方都可以睇到，但系好多时候都局限住，净系俾你喺船上面同佢哋影下相，就系咁样咯。而我自己要求咧，系真系想跳落去水里面，可以同佢哋有近距离接触，可以感受到佢哋个世界究竟系点。我影到少少佢条尾，啱啱反起咗上嚟，影到几好，影到喷水咯，你讲。咁而家地球上其實都係得兩笪地方係俾我哋可以咁樣潛落去水，而湯加就係其中一個地方咯。
We just got to locate the whales. Sometimes when they're sleeping, they can go very deep, so it can be hard to find them. So we're going to wait for them to go through another breathing cycle. Once they come up.We'll try and get a little closer to where they went in again, and then we'll go in and see if we can find them again.
In 南極嘅座頭鯨，每年嘅冬季都會遷徙到熱帶嘅海域。到底係咩吸引咗佢哋嚟湯加呢？
Very protected up here, both within the islands. We have great waters for them to raise their babies in. And the other one is they've migrated here for hundreds and hundreds of years. It's set into their heads to come to Tonga.
頭先聽阿 Karen 講咧，水下面嘅珊瑚生長得好健康嘅，有好多軟硬珊瑚啦，水又好清啦。咁而家我準備落去睇下水下面嘅世界點先。我自己是做 finance consultant 嘅，咁其實我都學咗潛水六年嘅啦。最初學咧諗住貪得意玩下，睇下水底世界啦。咁但係潛過水之後咧，就發覺其實我好中意潛水，因為其實我哋香港人咧做嘢工作壓力都幾大。咁潛水俾到我感覺，我就係可以好平靜、好寧靜，同埋成個人可以 refresh 咯。慣咗咧，每年都會出一兩個 trip 專登去潛水咯，因為水底世界咧，每一度咧都好唔同嘅。
前面有一條細嘅白鰭礁鯊，佢哋日頭咧就喺個洞度瞓覺，夜晚先會出嚟覓食。我本身咧就唔係好怕鯊魚嘅，其實佢哋見到人咧會仲驚，因為鯊魚咧係一啲好敏感嘅動物。見到我哋喺水裡面噴一啲氣泡出嚟嘅時候咧，咁佢哋就會驚到游開咗。荒家嘅水底咧，我已經睇過啦。但係仲未有機會可以同鯨魚一齊游水啊！希望可以快啲同佢哋接觸就好啦。
阿妹咁幸見到個座頭鯨，每年六七月到十月之間就會喺湯家一帶嘅水域交配同埋繁殖。紅色嘅座頭鯨會三五成群一齊向雌性求偶，競爭會持續幾個小時。慢慢競逐失敗的都會自己游走，剩下的雄性就會跟雌性交配。雌性的座頭鯨為了吸引雄性，通常都會用它的尾鰭或者刺鰭在水面敲擊，甚至跳出水面展示它美麗的身軀來吸引雄性的注意。
就係 Wawa 啦，咁係湯加主要其中一個島嶼。咁其實湯加有六個大島，另外好多百幾個細島形成。咁而依度嘅人咧，其實主要咧，佢哋都係靠出去做嘢寄錢翻嚟俾屋企人維生㗎。咁而第二咧就係靠旅遊業，咁去睇錯流鯨啦。
Wawa, this
is whale bone.
So they kill the whale and get the bone?
No, it's not allowed to kill a whale. Oh. It's a dead whale.
有很多咧鯨魚骨做的手工藝品就不是殺鯨魚攞嘅，因為1979年開始之後就不俾殺鯨魚咪喺度。
要追蹤座頭鯨，除了靠佢哋噴出嚟的水柱，佢哋經過的海面都會變得波平魚鏡。見到咁平滑的水面，我哋就會知道佢哋曾經喺呢一帶出沒過。
Go to where the blueprint was.
Is that I want to jump in first to make sure I can find him. If we can find him, then I'll have everyone else come in.
而家就揾緊一啲啱我哋適合落去，可以靜靜地近。見到佢嘅，咁而家就等要撞啱，要見到呢啲鯨魚咯。
Everybody ready?
Yeah.
Go, guys, go! Ready, go for it.
好近接觸到佢哋，個 B B 一路都係喺媽媽身邊黐住，好近佢，喺佢肚下面啊，或者喺背脊上面，咁咧喺個水底靜咗停喺度嘅。因為 B B 咧好細只嘅啫，3-4米度，咁佢隔6-7分鐘，佢就要上嚟唞氣噶啦。咁咧，佢上嚟唞氣嘅時候咧，媽媽咧就會輕輕扶住佢，等佢可以上去水上面唞氣。咁我記得有一個位咧，其實啱啱我同 B B 個 eye contact 咧，突然間眼望眼啦，個感覺就係佢喺南極咁遠遊上嚟。媽媽又係咁遠遊上嚟，我又香港咁遠落到嚟呢度，咁大家終於可以見到一面啦。我自己都第一次見到咁大，即係咁近，講緊係1米距離咁樣咧，我自己都有少少驚，見到佢翼係咁咦喐喐，咁就已經好咁上咗水。其實好靚嘅佢哋啲姿勢。喘完氣，咁佢哋要落翻10米、8米，咁停咗喺度，咁我感覺就好得意咯。媽媽一路保護住呢個小 B B 咁。
座頭鯨係哺乳類動物，鯨魚嘅孕育期大約係10個月，每胎會生一個。幼鯨出生之後，會跟住媽咪嘅身邊，學習生存嘅技能。1年之後。母鯨就會離開幼鯨，等佢自己過獨立嘅生活。
耶！
終於睇到啦，好大條啊！好大條，個媽媽同埋個 B B 一齊，個媽媽有成15-16米長，好大條 ，B B 有3-4米，好近啊！
Tony 是來自新加坡資深的水底攝影師，七年前開始他每年都會來到這裡看鯨魚，幫他們拍照和做記錄，而整理好的資料就會放上網，那不單止可以跟其他人分享，也都可以方便他以後研究的工作。 Tony 會將座頭鯨編號和根據身上的特徵幫他們改名，例如這隻叫做 Scratch， 因為它的尾鰭有很多花痕，而這隻就叫做白塊，因為它兩邊身都有白色的斑塊。
When earlier this year when we identified this whale, which if you compare the two, it's exactly the same, so we were able to show beyond a shadow of a doubt that one, the same whale came back to Vavau here in Tonga 2 years in a row, and also showed that she had a baby both last year and this year. As far as I know, it's the first time that anything like this has been documented here.
Got a whale. Go in and take a look.
以前 Tony 都是上班一族，每日朝九晚五在寫字樓上班，不過自從在大海裡面接觸過鯨魚之後， Tony 的生命就有很大的轉變。
Swimming with the whales and doing some of the other things that I have a chance to do now showed me that there's a lot more to life and that the world is a much bigger place than, you know, your office, the client's office,the hotels and the airports, which is where I lived my life before. As part of my thought process, you know, the whales helped me see there's a lot more and changed my life and the way that I try to, you know, influence other people as well. If you live in a city, you never really come into contact with nature. And when they come here and they get in the water,and they actually have a whale come really close, we're talking a few meters away, it's a life-changing experience. And every year there's new surprises. So even though it's the same place and the same type of animal, it's different every time we come.
South Pacific humpback whales, the adults can grow up to about 15 meters for the males and 16 meters for the females.
飛人除了帶遊客去觀鯨之外，有時佢都會為遊客講解座頭鯨嘅知識。
But generally only the male whales sing. Females and males will make different noises to communicate with each other. However, the song is traditional of a male. This is what the song sounds like. Thank you very much.
Karen 示范点样帮座头鲸录音，原来是要将一个海底的麦克风放落九米深的水底，接驳录音机就可以收集他们唱歌的声音，将歌声输入电脑分析，可以发现座头鲸的歌声是由重复的旋律组成，每段旋律可持续10至20分钟，而一首歌可以唱成几个钟头。
听到佢唱歌啊，尖尖地声细细声噶，啊！不过净系听到声又未见到佢。咁而家我哋喺度咧，等紧佢再，头先佢上过一次嚟唞气。跟住咧，如果佢再上多次嚟唞氣咧，咁我去喺 keep 住停留喺度，我哋就可以落去去揾佢哋咯。
我終於可以再次落水了，可以近距離聽到他們唱歌。他們的歌聲是很響亮，在很遠的距離都可以聽到。當我游到他們身邊的時候，整身都會感受到震動的。
座頭鯨只有雄鯨才會唱歌，有人認為這是他們向雌鯨求偶的表現，亦都有人認為他們是向其他鯨魚展示實力的一個方式。真正的答案就只有他們才知道。
不知道是不是我嚇親他們呢，啲鯨魚慢慢游走了。其實在一生人裡面呢，不是有很多機會呢可以跟這麼大的動物一起游水。我呢就好快要離開湯加群島返返香港做嘢了，而佢哋呢就要返返南極。雖然我唔知道咩時候可以再聽到呢啲鯨魚嘅聲，但呢啲咁特別嘅歌聲呢我永遠都會記得囉。如果下次潛水再聽到嘅時候，我就會知道原來我哋又再喺埋同一笪地方了。